A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 18th May, on the front page you have BSP, SP and Trinamool will not support a BJP-led government, Rahul. So Congress Chief Rahul Gandhi has clearly stated so and has also accused Election Commission of bias and hinted at post-poll alliance. And the other side, BJP said we'll come back to power with a majority of our own. That is PM Modi. He describes long campaign as a Thanksgiving exercise to the people. Then this is Supreme Court lifts stay on arrest of Rajiv Kumar. So Rajiv Kumar, his former Kolkata Police Commissioner. So a stay had been put by Supreme Court on his arrest, but now this stay has been lifted. So Bengal IPS officer has a week to appeal. So this is in the context of Sardha Chit Fund scam case. The CBI had flown down into Kolkata for his arrest. So the Supreme Court has given Mr. Kumar 7 days time, 1 week to appeal to the competent court for legal remedies. And till that time, he cannot be arrested. After that, the CBI has been asked to act in accordance with law. Then below you have no move for nationwide NRC exercise. So the central government has clarified that the National Register of Citizens exercise, which is going on in the state of Assam, there where illegal citizens are being identified and would be deported through foreigners tribunals. So this is not going to happen nationwide. Then on page 5 you have Varanasi has only one air quality monitoring station. So Varanasi has been ranked among the top 3 most polluted cities in the world, but it has only one air quality monitoring station. So this is shown here, the PM2.5 levels across these top 15 cities in the world, top 15 most polluted cities, of which Varanasi, you can see, clearly stands third. But air quality monitoring is also a problem because there is only one air quality monitoring station. Then this is center stand and BJP's words differ on countrywide NRC. So, in the party's manifesto, BJP has promised regarding this, and the government affidavit in the Supreme Court says there is no plan for a nationwide National Register of Citizens exercise. But the election promises that they will do that. On the editorial page, the first editorial is external woes. So this is regarding the widening trade deficit, which was in news yesterday. So given the widening trade deficit day before yesterday, so it says measures are needed to boost exports. So exports are falling and imports continue to be high, which is widening our trade deficit. And this is holding the center. So this is regarding how Europe's mainstay parties must not take fright at the perceived appeal of populism. So central, there are three aspects to political parties, ideologies, that is left, right and center. So holding the center is what the editorial is calling for, because right-wing extremism and right-wing political parties are gaining populism. But that's what the editorial says, that Europe's mainstream parties must not take fright at this perceived appeal of populism. And the lead article is a referendum on the Prime Minister. So this is a question raised, like it says Hindutva nationalism as embodied by Narendra Modi has remained the dominant narrative of the Lok Sabha courts. And below you have charting a clear course in the Indo-Pacific. So it says the Indo-Pacific wing of Ministry of External Affairs has given strategic coherence to India's look east policy. So it talks of how India has participated in this Shangri-La dialogue in June 2018, then the interest in the Indo-Pacific region which India has. Here you can see India's Act East policy is a bedrock of national Indo-Pacific vision. And ASEAN remains central to India's interests as such, Association of Southeast Asian Nations. Then we have the ASEAN Plus meetings, that is ASEAN Regional Forum 2, where 6 more countries come together. Then BIMSTEC, Bay of Bengal Initiative for Multisectoral Training and Economic Cooperation. So that also multi-sectoral technical and economic cooperation. So that also, then MGC, Mekong Ganga Economic Corridor, so all these initiatives, even the Indian Ocean Naval Symposium. So all these initiatives show how India is aware and has a clear course in the Indo-Pacific region. We are also boosting our engagement with Australia and Russia too. Then on Saturdays, you have a ground zero coverage on the op-ed page. So today, this is regarding the foot soldiers of Hindutva in West Bengal. So the violence has been, prominent in West Bengal during the elections. So it says, as ideological barriers give way and political activists switch sides, the BJP is relying on its tried and tested ways of getting into the mainstream on the strength of host of communal organizations. So that's what is going on in West Bengal too. And tensions flare up there. So rumors do the rounds during election time. So this is the ground coverage on this issue. On international page, you have 10 years since war, justice is still elusive. So this is regarding the Sri Lankan civil war. LTT got eliminated. It ended in 2009, and now it's been 10 years since then. Still, justice is elusive. So it says reconciliation is afar, because some survivors say that some lands are yet to be released and relatives are missing. So these are the concerns here. Then this is House Democrats concerned over Trump's India policy. So it asks President to appoint a permanent official for South Asia too. So they say there is a lack of leadership and policy coherence in US President Trump's India policy. And here you have, in a first for Asia, Taiwan bill legalizes same-sex marriage. So Taiwan's parliament legalized same-sex marriage. So this is the first such bill for Asia. And below you have, US delays decision on auto tariffs by 6 months. So US President Donald Trump announced that the steep tariffs will be imposed on imports of autos, auto imports, automobiles. So this would be delayed for 6 months presently, while US pursues talks with key trading partners. So the key trading partners here include European Union, Japan, Mexico, Canada. Then on business page, you have Air India arms privatization hits a bump. So this is regarding Air India Air Transport Service Limited, and that is Air India's ground handling arm. So government had proposed to privatize it, but now it has raised concerns here, because potential bidders have raised concerns over the Airport Authority of India's plan to award ground handling work at 76% of its at 76 of its airports to vendors. So this could impact the value of the entity up for sale. So if already ground handling will be provided by Airports Authority of India, then buying of this ground handling air traffic transport service limited of Air India, that does not become so attractive. On the last page, you have IMPAY, a pillar of modern architecture passes away. So this is regarding architect IMPAY. So he is known for his designs with sharp lines and stark structures. So he has designed this Louvre pyramid in Paris, and also this is a new Islamic museum of art in Doha. So he died recently. And finally, below you have, don't fall for misleading miracle cures on social media, doctors. So Tata Memorial Center has issued clarification for a second time now, urging people to not fall for such misleading miracle cures on social media, like WhatsApp messages, etc. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website, aasha.com. Thank you.